I finally found a way to really split floors in Revit. The cool thing is that this small tool can be used with model lines, curves, or even entire rooms. I think we needed more options than create parts or redrawing floors in Revit manually. So I tried to improve that. Let's jump into Revit. I'm going to first use the two floors in the left. And I'm going to split them using model lines, curves, and so on. And then I'm going to move into a little bit more advanced case with the building in the left, in the right, sorry. And use actual rooms to actually split floors and give different finishes. So yeah, for the first case, I'm going to start drawing a model line. This model line is going to be used to split the floors. So I'm just going to draw something like that. And then I'm going to move into cut floors. Here, I'm going to select the floors I want to split and then click on finish. Then I'm going to select the, the lines or rooms that I want to use. I'm going to select that one. And if I want to delete the selected model line, I do want to delete it, so I'm going to leave it marked. And then I'm just going to run. Great, so yeah, it is basically split the floors, so I can switch to different types. They are completely independent. And of course, we can do a little bit more complex stuff. For example, if we do have group of lines, something that goes like this, maybe, it's important that the lines or group of lines split the floors in two parts. And that we select one at the time. So for example, if I do select these two floors, I can select this group of lines. If I will have another one here, that will have to be in another execution. And then click on split floors. Great, so that also split the floors. But I think the best part of this small tool is when using splines, ellipses, and so on. So I think it's pretty cool when, let me show you, when I do have like an arc. No, let me do an ellipse, an spline maybe better, that follows some shape like this. Yeah. And then I can select the two floors I want to split and the line I want to use. And then I can cut them. Awesome. I can use that to actually have like a nice opening in different levels if I want to, something like that. But I think something a little bit different that I should actually show is when using circles or ellipses. For example, I'm gonna draw two of them, and with circles and ellipses I can select as many as I want in one run. So that's pretty nice. So if we have like different small areas using a spline or circles, we can select all of them. So I'm gonna select the two floors and then select the two circles and ellipses. And that also will split the floors. Yeah, we can again switch the types and so on. So that's it for the basic case, but of course we have the more advanced case in which I want to show you how to do that in a real building. So in this building we have this floor and we have like different rooms. So I'm gonna first select the floor and then I'm gonna select the rooms I want to split the floor for. So in this case the kitchen and the office. And then, well, this option for rooms, it doesn't really make any change because rooms will never be deleted, even if it's marked. So yeah, I can just run it. Yeah, as soon as I run it, we again have different floors split, so I can use them to give different finishes. It's pretty simple tool. Of course, has some limitation. So if you work with very weird rooms or shapes, you may find some limitations. But of course, we keep improving it, I wanted to leave you another video in which I explain another small tool to create openings in walls, floors, ceilings, and so on. It's pretty cool when you have like these pipes and beams going through walls, and you want to create the passes, the holes in those wall floors or holes. So feel free to have a look, and thanks for watching. Bye-bye.